Now that our display is prepared, we can begin to add our pie data. Contrary to static symbols, which are found mostly on the toolbar, dynamic symbols representing pie data are in the left-hand side's asset pane. If your asset pane is currently collapsed, you can expand it by clicking on the assets icon. Since this display is an overview of the North Dakota Division's oil production, our first item of interest is the average production rate for the entire state. On the assets pane, we'll drill down to the first level of the oil well production database and find our North Dakota asset. If we click on it, the attributes list underneath will populate with all attributes associated with the North Dakota asset. Find the average production rate attribute, and verify that your trend symbol is selected. Then, click and drag the average production rate attribute onto the display just beneath our text box that reads North Dakota production. The default stylings of the trend look okay, but what would look even better is if it had a white background to match the rest of our display. Right-click on the trend and select Format Trend. Under Trend Options, we can change the background, much like before, from a medium gray to white. We'll then resize the trend to occupy a narrow band below the display title. And now a trend of the present and historical oil production rates for the state is quite valuable, but alone, it results in a one-dimensional display. Let's take this one step further and break down the statewide production rate into contributions by each well residing in the state. Start by drilling into the oil well production database and then into the North Dakota element. Here we see a list of the well pads located in the state: Crosby, Dickinson, Kenmare, Stanley, and Williston. Each well pad is comprised of several individual wells, so drill down once more into the Crosby element to see which wells are located there. Find and click on Well 08, then the Location City attribute beneath the asset tree. Make sure the Asset Comparison table is selected, and then click and drag the Location City attribute onto the display just beneath the production rate trend. Resize this as needed to fill the space in the bottom right corner of the state outline. Since we're interested in more than just the city that each well is located, let's add some additional data columns to our table. Right-click on the table and select Configure Table to bring up the configuration pane. Under the Columns header, find and select Production Rate under Additional Attributes and click on the upward arrow to add the column to the table. We'll do the same for the Total Downtime and Weather attributes to provide a well-rounded overview of each well's operation. Like the trend symbol before it, the asset comparison table would look much nicer if it were lighter to match the white background features of the display. Luckily, we can do so by selecting the lighter color scheme under the Style header on the configuration pane. To finish prettying up our table, let's resize the whole thing and each one of the columns to make sure that none of the headers have any text cut off. And for the production rate and total downtime attributes, we're interested in displaying the units of measurement, which we can do by selecting the Show Units box under Current Columns in the Configuration pane. Up until now, our table has only displayed information for the Well 08, but we're really interested in listing all of the wells and comparing their production and downtime rates. Therein lies the beauty of the asset comparison table. We can display all of the wells simultaneously by configuring dynamic search criteria on the table based on commonalities between all of those wells, namely the shared template or blueprint each was created from. Right-click on the table once more and select Add Dynamic Search Criteria. Modify the search route to focus on all of North Dakota, and then click the checkbox to return all descendants and hit Refresh. Resize the symbol once more as needed.